and we will be wearing pink. Amen. And because I am the man that I am, amen, I'm going to wear pink. Probably some socks or something. We will wear pink next Sunday.
Oh, come on, family. Yeah. Yeah. Pink. Yeah. A pink shirt.
Amen. Praise the Lord. On the fourth Sunday, we will wear purple in honor of two things. Amen. Domestic violence, and we are going to dedicate, do the final dedication, unveiling our chair for Mother Grace Noble on the fourth Sunday. Mm-hmm. So we look for you to be here to share with us in those services. It is indeed a pleasure. Let me thank Holy Temple, Bishop Jewel R. Withers, and Lady Joyce Withers, the Holy Temple family, for such wonderful hospitality on last Sunday. When you talk about saints and talk about how saints treat you, amen, they are second to none.
Yes, sir.
They have my vote. They are second to none. I want to thank them so much for how they treated me and my wife and family and my church family on last Sunday with such intelligence and such respect and such hospitality. And a special thanks to Lady Ursy Herbie Walker, Ella Jo Brown, and to my niece Lindsay for doing such a wonderful job even before we got to Holy Temple on last Sunday. The week prior, they were calling and they were seeing if we needed anything special. So I want to appreciate them. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I want to talk to you on this morning. If you will pray with me. I know my brothers are with me today. I want to talk to you this morning about don't lose your confidence. Lose your confidence.
Yes.
And I ask God to give me a message that would reach adults and young folk alike. Don't lose your confidence. I want you to know how important it is to keep your confidence. And in a season that we're in now, it is important to keep your confidence. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
See the baby. That's a baby. Praise the Lord. Keep your confidence. Keep your confidence. Thank God for Sister Erica, one of our baby saints. Thank God for young folks. Praise the Lord. Let me say, amen, that I want to, our text today, amen, is going to be taken, amen, from the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verses 35 through 37. The book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verses 35 through 37. God bless. So glad to see my baby Isha coming again. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
It's a blessing. It's been her children. Praise the Lord. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord today. Today is a good day.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Every second Sunday, we will celebrate our youth. Every second Sunday. So we're going to ask you to share. Thank God for Olivia's brothers, two of her brothers being here today. God bless them. Amen. We thank God for her mother also. God bless her and her auntie. Praise God. Yes. Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 35 through 37. What we want to talk about. We give honor to, and we recognize Mother Kim Robinson, Keita Holt.
Yeah.
We recognize Mother Irma J. Pendleton.
Yeah.
Amen. And let her know we are praying for her. Hebrews chapter 10, verses 35 through 37 says it like this. It says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which has great recompense of the Lord. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. For yet a little while, and he that shall come will come, and will not tarry.
Yeah.
May God bless. His word is already blessed.
Yeah.
We thank God for the word. Don't lose your confidence.
Yeah.
Don't lose your confidence. Sister Brenda.
All right, Pastor.
I want you to be reminded of that. Our text today. Be reminded of what our text says on today. How important it is to keep up your confidence in God. David the psalmist says to us, he has been young and now he has become old. But he has never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Above all obstacles, build your confidence in God. Make it a priority. Put it at the top of your list of things to do. That's young as well as old. Our text says, cast not away therefore your confidence, which has great recompense of reward. For ye have need of patience, that after ye have done the will of God, ye might receive the promise. The text says, for yet a little while, and he that shall come will come, and will not tarry. In other words, hold up, hold on to your boldness, seeing that it belongs to great reward. The Bible says to us, for he that endureth to the end shall be saved. Mm-hmm. Let me ask you a question in this message. During these times of uncertainty, how is your endurance?
My God.
I need to ask it again because y'all quiet. During these times of uncertainty, how is your endurance? Look at the word confidence. Well, confidence means the feeling or belief that one can rely on someone or something. Firm trust. The state of feeling certain about the truth of something. A feeling of self-assurance that when I tell you my secret, it won't be spreaded in the streets by today.
All right.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. And then let us look at the word recompense, meaning make amends to someone for loss or harm suffered to compensate. And I know all of us like to be compensated every now and then.
Yeah.
Pay or reward someone for effort or work.
Yes, sir.
Make amends to or reward someone for loss, harm, or effort. There is a reward in keeping your confidence. The Apostle Paul says to us in Romans 8, 38 and 39, for I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Years ago, McFadden and Whitehead wrote, this is for my little brother, Prophet Haynes. Years ago, McFadden and Whitehead wrote and produced a song called Ain't No Stopping Us Now. We're on the move.
Watch out, Pastor.
Ain't no stopping us now.
Yes, sir.
Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Yes. It said we got the groove. There's been so many things that held us down. But now it looks like things are finally coming around.
Yes, sir.
I know we've got a long, long way to go. And where we'll end up, I don't know. But we won't let nothing hold us back. Just a moment. We're putting ourselves together. We're polishing up our hands. Well, and if you've been held down before, don't y'all act like y'all don't know it. I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Well, don't you let nothing Nothing. Somebody said nothing.
Nothing.
Stand in your way. I don't know why it is we get saved and sanctified and we just act like we forgot the song. You ain't forgot the song. You might not sing it no more, but you ain't forgot it.
Come on, Pastor.
Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Oh, somebody said, Pastor, I thought you would save all your life. I hope you save all my life. Oh, bless the name. I thank God I'm saved now.
Yes.
But I want to tell you, listen to every word I say. Ain't no stopping us now. We're on the move. Keep going. Let no one and nothing stop you. Let no one break your stride. Proverbs 3:5-6 says to us, trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Lean not unto thine own understanding. Says to us, in all thy ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct thy path.
Come on, preacher.
Verse 7 and 8, Lord have mercy. And 9 tells us, because we get excited when we read Proverbs 3:5-6.
Come on, Pastor.
But every moment we don't never read. Sometimes we don't read verses 7, 8, and 9. But this is what it says. It says, but be not wise in thy own eyes. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. In other words, don't just have confidence in your abilities, but have confidence in God. And then verse 8 says, it shall be health to thy neighbor and marvel to thy bones. Verse 9 comes along and says, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thine increase. Lord have mercy. All of you money fighters and tithe fighters, this is what the Bible is saying to you. It says, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thine increase. I cannot leave out verse 10 since I read 7, 8, and 9. But verse 10 says, if you will honor the Lord with your first fruits and all your substances, the verse 10 says, so shall thy barn be filled with plenty, and thy presses shall burst out with new wine. The old will be no more, but you have been bought with a price. Because of the confidence that I have now, I'm forgetting those things that are behind me. Lord have mercy. Is there anybody here that can say these words? They said I wouldn't make it, but I'm here today. They said I wouldn't be here, but thank God I'm here today. They said I'd be dead, but thank God I'm living. They said I'd be in jail, but thank God I'm here. I'm walking and breathing. I'm talking. Yes, I am. Nobody can stop me. I'm on the Lord's side. Your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, don't touch them, but tell them, neighbor, I am a living testimony. I should have been dead, I should have been gone, but I'm still alive. I'm still alive. Yes, I am. I'm pressing toward the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. My confidence is higher than ever. My daily request to God, Lord have mercy, and let my life be the mirror that reflects the image of Christ. Yeah, I've got strong confidence that God gonna keep you the word. Somebody said, God, give my everything. I'm not giving up. No ground to the enemy. My eyes are focused on Jesus. My ears are attentive to what God is saying, to what God is asking. My mouth is open to every praise belongs to him. Every praise belongs to him. not too yet. Abraham. Do y'all remember Abraham? I know my brothers, Ella Haynes, and Ella Mullins, and Ella Lindy. Remember Abraham. Abraham, young people, took his son Isaac to Mount Moriah to be sacrificed. God told Abraham, he said, take your son. Y'all hear what I'm saying? He told Abraham, he said, take your son, your only son, the son that you love. Even though this was a test of Abraham's faith, Abraham didn't know it. Lord have mercy. What this shows is that Abraham had utterly come to trust God, Erica. He said, God, because you said it, I'm going to do it. This is my child. This is my baby. But because you said it, I'm going to stand on it. I'm going to go to Mount Moriah. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. In the midst of your most difficult times, we must learn to trust God. Sometimes when we don't understand what God is doing, why God is taking us the long way, when there is a shorter and similar way, we must trust God. We can, when we cannot trace Him, remember God. This is what I want you to hear. Remember God. First Lady knows the plans He has for us. Plans of good and not of evil. To give us an expected end. Our expectations should be high as the skies. God said, His ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. Lord have mercy. I gotta talk to somebody here. Maybe you're sitting in your house. Maybe you're here today, but you've been in a dark place. Lord have mercy. Is there anybody here? Ever lift your hand and say, Pastor, I've been in a dark place in my life, but I need to tell you, the light has come. Don't let the enemy trip you up. Stay in the fight. The battle is not yours. I'm in the fight. Yes, I am. The battle is not yours. It is the Lord. Stay on in there. Stay in the fight. Stay in there. Yes. Lord, have mercy. Need to close. I didn't want to be too long. But Jonathan Nelson said it like this, prophet. He said, my name is victory. I've got evidence. I've got confidence. I'm a conqueror. Lord have mercy. I know that I win. I know who I am. God wrote it. It is planned for me. Look at your neighbor and tell him, my name is victory. God gave me authority. Lord have mercy. The conquering him. He wrote it in my destiny. My name is victory. My name is victory. I want you to look at your neighbor. Don't touch him. But tell him, let me introduce myself. In victory, yeah. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Prophet Haynes, this is what he said. He said, I'm an overcomer. I know I've already won. He wrote it in my destiny that my name is victory. I know who I am. And then I know whose I am. God wrote it in His plan for me. Oh, my name. My name is victory. I know my identity. My name is victory. Victory. That's my name. I know who I am. Yeah. Lord, have mercy. You didn't do like some of us do now. We are called on Friday, but by Sunday, we are bishops. Lord, have mercy. But I want you to hear this. Paul set an example. He set an incredible precedence for ministers and leaders and young folk throughout these ages. Paul, you must understand, did not dive into the ministry right away, even though he was a trained Pharisee and knew the Old Testament in and out. He intentionally took time to study and pray. Lord have mercy. As I studied God's word, he said Paul went away for 3 years to Arabia to study the word of God before his ministry truly began. The Bible said that Paul instructed the Thessalonians to rejoice always. I need to tell you that whatever's going on in your life, just lift your hand and rejoice always. Always give God praise. Always magnify him. Always glorify him. Don't look down, but look up. God is up. Lift your head up. All ye lands, clap your hands, all ye people. Paul not only instructed them in right, but he exemplified a faithful prayer life. Paul recognized, Lord have mercy, that there is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is neither male nor female. For we are all one in Christ Jesus. Paul simply understood the common denominator of humanity. We get so caught up in male and females. Lord have mercy, whether God called you or not. We get so caught up, somebody not gonna like me, but that's all right. You can't lose a friend that you never had. You gotta come out of this mess. You gotta stop all of these traditions, some of this tradition stuff. We gotta end it. But a woman don't belong in the pulpit. A woman belong in the house, cooking meals, taking care of family. But somebody forgot to tell some of these men that the Bible said if a man don't work, he don't eat. We're supposed to take care of what God put you in charge of. You're the head, whether you like it or not. God made you the head. And because Paul's message was to everybody, he practiced ways that people from all walks of life understood it. You see, we judge folk because they don't walk like we walk. They don't speak in tongue like we speak in tongue. They don't dress like we dress. Lord have mercy, don't get mad at the young sisters, because you're not young no more, and your dress is down to your ankle, but her dress is just a little above her knees, and you got a problem with it. I want to tell you that God don't look at what you're wearing, but he look at the heart. When the heart get right, you'll dress right. When the heart get right, you'll talk right. When the heart get right, you'll treat everybody right. Say it! Paul kept his confidence. I don't know why the Holy Ghost want me to slow down. But Paul kept his confidence in the God of his salvation. Paul was stoned multiple times. He had countless beatings. He faced many dangerous conditions. He faced threatening thieves. He had many sleepless nights and even starvation. But in spite of his difficult days, Paul did not lose his confidence. Paul praised God, never losing hope. Paul, the Bible says, wrote two letters to his spiritual son Timothy, even while in prison, encouraging Timothy to stand strong. I leave you today with this. Let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap. If we thank God, keep your confidence in God. I hear the Bible say, for I reckon that the suffering of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Lord, have mercy. Psalm 139, verses 13 and 14 says, for thou hast possessed my reins. Thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wrongly wonderful made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. Lord, have mercy. In 2 Chronicles 32 and 8, Hezekiah said to the people, he said, with him is an arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord. The Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. And the people rested themselves upon the words of Hezekiah, king of Judah. I need to tell you what God says. God said this: if you want to give up, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. This is what God said. And I'm finished. He said, my grace sufficient for you, but my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness, so that Christ's power may rest upon us. The Bible said, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a power of love, of a sound mind. Another version of the Bible says this. Says it like this. Hear me good. For the spirit God gave us does not make us timid.
Right.
Okay. Well, y'all right. Catch that.
All right.
For the spirit God gave us does not profit make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline.
Yeah.
I need to read that again because somebody didn't catch that. For the spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Listen, don't lose your confidence. Bless off. Don't do it. Stop allowing people to have the power over you.
Come on, preacher.
Yeah. I'm glad it's you there.
Yes, come on.
I want to say this just for the young people. Don't let nobody bully you. Uh-huh. No, something to your boss. Hey. Don't let nobody intimidate you.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
I've learned this habit, young people. This is what I learned. And me and my brothers, we agree on this. When you talk to a person, you look them in the eye.
Yeah,
I agree.
I don't know, I can't remember the names of Olivia's brothers, but y'all tall young men, one of y'all played football. But you know what makes a person confident in you?
Come on, preach.
Is that when you talk to a person, you look them in the eye. One of the worst things you can do is talk to people looking down. They know you're lying. Y'all looking, y'all quiet. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Talk to people, and while you're talking to them, you're looking down. We already know you're lying. When you go to a job, you go to a job confident.
Yeah.
This youth day. Amen. Go to that job confident. Let them know you're not afraid. You're there to do a job. You're going to respect them, but you're there to do a job. I want to tell you something, young ladies and young men. You can make folks respect you.
That's
it. Do I have a witness in the house?
Amen.
You can make folk respect you. Mm-hmm. Young ladies, when a man come up to you, young man, and he wants to talk to you any kind of way, he want to spit that game on you.
Uh-oh.
Game that went out the door 20 years ago.
What they need to do, Pastor?
Yeah, yeah. Because if they had a real game, they'd have a job.
Oh!
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. And I'm going to tell you, young ladies, and I'm not afraid to tell you, you don't have to show your body to get attention. That's a sign of you losing your confidence.
Yeah.
You don't have to show your body to get attention. God made you who you are.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. I want to tell you something. And this is one of my pet peeves. And my wife, she knows she loves this when I say this. God made you. Whoa, man.
Yeah.
That's when a man look at you, he says, whoa, man.
Whoa,
man. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. Then. Y'all didn't catch that. Huh?
Come on, Pastor.
When I met my wife over 36 years ago, I looked at her, I said, whoa, man.
Yes,
huh? Yeah. Uh-huh. God made you. And he made us to be men. Huh? He made us to be men. Hey, listen. I don't need my wife to pet me. I'm going to pet her. I'm going to spoil her. Yeah, every now and then, yeah, let your husband know you love him. Let him know you appreciate what he's doing. Hallelujah. It's one thing for sure that myself, Prophet Hayes, and Ella Bullers, and Ella Lindy, we have agreement on, because they hear me say this all the time. I believe that a man ought to stand up and be a man. One of the worst things you can be is a weak man. And I just because you cry, that don't make you weak.
No,
everybody cry every now and then. I cry every now and then. But know this, I'm a man.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, sir.
Young men, I want to encourage you today on Youth Day to be men. Be men. You ain't supposed to walk in the house with your wife and you tell her to go in the house first and check it while you wait outside. It's their mother, they ain't gonna like me. It's all right to give your husband somebody sometime, but most of the time, listen, you ought to be the man. You ought to be the man.
Amen.
She ought to be able to go to you and ask you for some money. She ought not have to worry about the bill. If you ask my wife how much the light bill, she don't know, cause she don't pay.
Don't know. I ain't trying to find out.
Hallelujah. Sometimes I'm tired, Prophet. I'm tired. I'm worn down. And a lot of times, and going so much and doing so much. And my daughter, Serenity, who I love dearly, anything happened at the car, if the tire not right, she called Daddy.
That's right.
Daddy, my tire is kind of low, Daddy. One day I said, girl, I said, what is it now? And it came to me. That's the way I told her. I'm her man until she get one. And I hope I'm still a man after she get one. Hallelujah. I'm trying to help you. I preach the gospel today. But I'm trying. Don't lose your confidence, young ladies. Don't lose your confidence, men of God. Hallelujah. If a man really respect you, then he ought to do what the Bible says. The Bible says a man that findeth the wife. Find the good thing and obtain the favor from the Lord.
Woo.
If he loved you, he should have put a ring on it. Yeah. Y'all folks gonna learn your pastor hip too. That's what Beyonce said. You should have put a ring on it. Yeah, you should have put a ring on it. If you love, But I love you, but I don't know if I'm going to be with you, so I want to live together. The devil is alive. Don't let him use your body up. Hallelujah. Don't let him use your mind up. Then when somebody do want to marry you, all worn down. And the person that married you got to deal with that. Sick every day because you done wore your body down.